Hello, this is a part of IEEE 802.11 TKIP video series on securitytube.net. In this video, I'll be talking more about TKIP working, how exactly the TKIP packet is encrypted, and how exactly it is decrypted with the help of initialization vector, or known as TKIP sequence counter, and the encryption keys. TKIP involves most of the features of a good encryption algorithm. A good encryption algorithm should never use the master key directly for encryption, as TKIP uses the session keys or derives session key from the master key, which are actually used for encryption and decryption, but actual master key is not used for decryption. Now again, per packet key mixing mechanism further makes the encryption algorithm more stronger, and it derives a separate unrelated key for each packet. Now this each packet or per packet keys are derived with the TKIP sequence counter TSC and with the help of session keys. How exactly they have derived, I have explained it more in more detail in TKIP sequence counter video. I will be briefly explaining how encryption is taking place in this video. Now to save the computation, key mixing is derived into two parts. First part is not so often required part, and second part is actually done for every packet. So in phase one, it involves data that is relatively static, like secret session key, higher order 32 bits, initialization vector, MAC addresses, etc. Now for a communication or for a session, MAC addresses are not going to change. At least source and destination MAC addresses are always going to be, if the transmitter is client, then source will be of client MAC and destination will be access points MAC. So MAC addresses are not going to change. Higher order 32 bit IV is again not going to change so frequently, and secret session key is going to be constant for a session. So with the help of these things, which are not changing very oftenly, phase one part is done, and with the help of phase one computation, one key mixing part of the vector is derived. It is now, since this computation is going to be non-frequent, the more complex computational or more computationally extensive algorithm can be used in this part of mixing. Now the phase 2, which is a frequent key mixing thing, it should be very quick. So simple addition and shift things are used in phase 2. So phase 2 is quicker to compute and is done for each packet, and it uses lower 16 order bit IV mainly, which increases monotonically with every packet. So for packet 1, the IV should start with 0, and for every successive packet, the initialization vector or TKIP sequence counter should go on increasing. So to reduce the computation, it has been divided into two phases. Now let's directly go into the TKIP transmission block. Now for TKIP transmission block, the inputs are the MSDU for the transmission, or MAC service data unit, which has to be transmitted, and either party involved in communication, that is client and access point, typically they have already shared the secret, which is a master key. Now with the help of key derivation block and with the help of master key and four-way handshake and other things, the MIC key or Michael key is derived. Along with that, encryption key and other KEK, KCK and other keys are also derived from key derivation unit. Now the MIC key or Michael key or message integrity code check key and the MSDU MIC, actual MIC is computed, and that MIC is appended to MSDU itself. As we know, MIC will appear only once per MSDU and not per MPDU. So now here you have MSDU appended with MIC clear text. Now this frame is given to fragmentation block, and if required, the fragmentation is done. Now after fragmentation is done, there is a separate IV generator, you know. IV generator is monotonic increasing function. So for every packet, IV generator will go on incrementing. So IV generator will give a IV or initialization vector. Now with the help of initialization vector and a fragmented packet, the IV is appended to the fragmented packet and IC is computed. You know, you have fragmented packet and you have initialization vector, so you can easily find out IV and ICV. So here, for every packet, you have IV, then you have fragmented clear text packet, and you have ICV. You may or may not have MIC depending upon whether the fragmentation is done or not. Now, the same IV will go as an input to key mixing block. Now, as we have discussed in TSC video or TKIP sequence counter video, how exactly key mixing is done. For key mixing, you have two parts, phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 inputs are lower order 2 bytes of IV, then your encryption keys, and then other frequently changing inputs. And for stage 2, the inputs are again higher order 4 bytes of IV, MAC addresses and encryption keys. Now with that key mixing block, you have key stream. Now you have here your actual packet. Now with the help of your actual packet and key stream, actual encryption is done, and once the packet is encrypted, it is transmitted. It's a MPDU, MAC protocol data unit, and it is transmitted. So this block is very much similar to your RC4 block. The inputs for this block are key mixing is already done. So inputs to RC4 are generally 3 bytes of IV and the key which is present. Now in TKIP, the key is not used directly, but after key mixing, a separate key is used. So that whole part is this RC4 block. Before RC4 block, key mixing part is here. Actually, key mixing is shown in RC4 block here itself, but actually RC4 key mixing is not exactly done in RC4 block. Otherwise, it's pretty much clear. This upper block is Michael block where MIC is calculated. Here key streams, key derivation is done, and here actually encryption and transmission is done. In next slide, we'll be talking about how exactly reception is done of this transmitted packet.